already made a table yesterday in which last one was remaining. That was continuous frequency distribution. So understand it first, then you'll write it. Third type of question is continuous frequency distribution. I told you, how would you identify, is it a question on ungrouped or discrete or continuous? In ungrouped you will be given with
only
xi, only xi, that means observations. In discrete you will be given with observations xi and frequency fi, and in continuous you will be given with classes and frequency. Now we are seeing all the types of questions by two methods, direct method and shortcut method. By direct method, the formula will remain same as discrete. Same as discrete means sigma fi xi upon n. Only one point you have to keep in mind. Xi will be the mid values. Now you will not be given with xi, you will be given with classes. So how will we find the xi in the question? Mid values. How do you find the mid values? Raise your hand. Last chapter we studied that. How can you find the mid values? Even yes, lower limit of given class plus upper limit of given class divided by 2. By shortcut method, the formula will become a plus. Up till now we have done sigma fi di upon n. Now you will do into c, where up till now di was obtained as xi minus a. Now you will do divide by c, and c is the class length. If it's a continuous frequency distribution or common factor, if it's a discrete frequency distribution. Even discrete frequency distributions you can do it by this formula when there is a common factor. Like yesterday the discrete frequency distribution we did in the class. See what were the values of xi? In the class what we saw discrete frequency distribution. What were the values of xi in that xi fi? What were the values of xi? First question, what did it? 30, 30. 35, 40, 45, 50. Do you find any common factor in that? What is that? 5. So there also we can apply this formula. But then every time in discrete frequency distribution, common factor will not be there. So we don't do that. And as such, I told you, ungrouped and discrete will always be doing by which method? Direct method. Okay? Otherwise, you can apply this formula in discrete also. All illustrations, all of you could get the answers.
Yes.
Give them all by direct method.
Yes.
Now here if nothing is mentioned, we will always be doing it by shortcut method. That will be better. In continuous frequency distribution, we will not apply direct method. We will apply shortcut method. What is the additional part in this formula? Now why into C? Di is divided by C. To cancel the effect of division by C, we do into C. Like what do you do with AU? Minus. To cancel its effect, we do plus A. Same way we divide by C. So to cancel its effect, we do into C. Is everyone okay clear with it? But in continuous frequency distribution, we will be using which formula? Shortcut method. Any doubts in that? No doubt this in the same summary table. Space must be there. Ungrouped and discrete where we have written, below that write down continuous. So same way like yesterday here, one question I'll explain you by direct and shortcut method. Just for understanding, both the methods will do, otherwise majority questions we will always be doing by shortcut method. One more thing you can mention in this summary. We will be applying this shortcut method when class lengths are equal. In case if class lengths are unequal, then you cannot apply this method. because then C will not be common. You will not have a common class length. Then you cannot apply this method. So if class lengths are unequal, then you have to apply direct method. If class lengths are unequal, then we will apply direct method. If class lengths are equal, then we will always apply shortcut method. Is anyone clear with this? Viraj, you have also not done the homework? So you are waiting for me to ask you to stand up? Oh, don't try to be so innocent. Don't try to be so. You do it 3 times by tomorrow. All the homework questions of yesterday, 3 times by tomorrow, okay? Now, all of you have completed the formula?
Yes.
This whole table of formulas, 26 formulas are there. Compulsory for everyone, 10 times by tomorrow. You can use the shortcuts in headings, meaning you can write DM for direct method, SF for short method, ungrouped UN, discrete DISC, continuous UND. Formulas, there are no shortcuts. In headings, you can use it. But 10 times compulsory so that you don't get 100 times on next time. See that all of you write all the formulas 10 times and come. And any time I ask you, you must be able to answer. Look at exercise 3.1, question 4. Page 79. Understand it properly. One I am doing on the board. One I will explain you. One you will explain me. Anyone of you touching the whiteboards? Yes, now. Page 79. Exercise 3.1. Question 4. I'll explain you one question by both the methods. One I'll ask you by short method and one you'll try on your own. The marks in a test for a group of students are as follows. Find the mean marks of these students. See the marks, they are classes and number of students are frequencies. First question, so I'll explain you by both the methods. Direct method as well as short method. So, write down classes and frequencies. No discussions in between, silence. Did you write the classes and frequencies? Now understand the direct method first. Very first of all, in direct method we require xi, which is the mid value. Without xi, we cannot find f by xi. Okay, and your xi is not available, classes are available. So how to find the mid value? Understand it. As I said, lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. So 0 plus 10 divided by 2 is 5. Able to understand this, then 10 plus 20, 30 divided by 2 is 15. Now everyone listen, whatever I am explaining in next question, if you are not able to answer, your cons. So I need everyone to concentrate when I am explaining something. When class lengths are same, what you can do is, what is the class length? 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, up to 60 to 70. What is the class length?
10.
When class lengths are same, find the first mid value and keep on adding the class length. Like what is the class length here? 10. So 5 plus 10? 15 plus 10? 25 plus 10? 25 plus 10? Plus 10? Plus 10? But you can do this only if class lengths are equal. Otherwise, you have to count lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. Every class length you have to count. If class lengths are unequal. Able to understand this? What can we do when the class lengths are equal? Find the first mid value and keep on adding the class length. Let it go. Anyone not clear with the mid values? So once again, what will you do? First mid value you will find and then keep on adding the class length. Only when class lengths are equal. Otherwise, every mid value you will find by lower limit plus upper limit divided by 2. Shall I proceed further? Everyone has written it?
Yes.
Now, as per the formula sigma fi xi upon n, we need fi into xi. that we did in discrete also yesterday. So fi xi is required. These two will be multiplied. Fi xi means these two will be multiplied. Okay. So you can use that memory functions. Take out the calculators. Is the screen memory empty right now?
Yes.
Do 3 into 5 m plus. You get 50? Write it also. Keep writing it also, okay? Then 5 into 15 m plus. You get 75?
Yes, sir.
12 into 25 m plus. You get 300? 60 into 35 m plus. You get 560? 11 into 45 m plus, 495. 5 into 55 m plus, 275. 6, 4 into 65 m plus, 260. Now press MR. 1980. So your labor will be saved on doing the total. Okay. Who are able to get this 1980 from MR? Very good. Is everyone clear with this? And 3, 8, 20, 36, 47, 52, 56. Do the total of FI all of you. Got this? Everyone got 56? You did not get. All clear up till here? Now we'll apply the direct method right on by direct method. X bar is equal to sigma fi xi upon n. Okay, by direct method x bar equals to sigma fi xi upon n. What is sigma fi xi we obtained? 1980. And n is the total of frequency, that is 56, 30, 5.35, then 7, so make it 36. If the third digit is 5 or more than 5, then round out to the next digit. If it is less than 5, then keep the same digit. Is everyone clear with this? Now same question, we'll understand how to do by shortcut method. Who are still doing this? All are clear up till here? For shortcut method, write the classes and frequencies again. Did you all write the classes and frequencies, everyone? Here also mid values are required. Without mid value, you cannot find DI. So mid value in all continuous frequency distributions will be required, whether you apply direct method or short method. So as we discussed, 0 plus 10 divided by 2, 5. After that, keep on adding 10. So 15, 25, 35, 45, 55, and 65. Now, first, we will understand DI with the concept and calculations. And then we'll understand how to directly get it without any calculations. Okay? DI's formula is xi minus a upon c. First of all, assumed mean we will select from xi. Generally, the middlemost value we should take as assumed mean. So 35 we select as assumed mean. Okay, mark it as a. Understood that? Now DI is equal to xi minus assumed mean 35 divided by class length is 10. Xi minus assumed mean is 35 and class length is 10. So formula is xi minus a upon c. Did you all write this? Xi minus 35 upon 10. Now, first we understand it from the calculations. Means from all observations, we have minus 35 and divide 10. Do it by minus 35 divide by 10. Do you get minus 3?
Yes,
Understood how is this obtained? Then do 15 minus 35 divided by 10. You get minus 2. Then do 25 minus 35 divided by 10 minus 1. Then do 35 minus 35 divided by 10 0. Then do 45 minus 35 divided by 10 1. Then do 55 minus 35 divided by 10 2. Then do 65 minus 35 divided by 10 3. All of you have given the actual calculations how they are done. Now listen everyone. What we will do without the calculations is in front of A, in front of
A,
write 0. Above that minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, whatever observations are there. Below that 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. You'll always get it correct only if class lengths are
equal.
And in fact we are going to apply this formula only when class lengths are
equal.
Otherwise we'll apply the direct method. Okay. So how will you directly get the values of D? In front of A, assume mean, you will write 0. Above that? Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Below that? 1, 2, 3 and so on. Understood that? Any confusions? Now we require as per the formula F by DI. As per the formula what we need is now F by DI. F by DI means these two are to be multiplied. By mistake, don't multiply x by di, because we are habituated of multiplying two close values. So it normally happens that whatever values are close, you multiply pi into minus 3. It's wrong. It's not x by di, it is f by di. So f by is to be multiplied with di. Got it everyone? So 3 into minus 3. Now in calculators, don't do 3 into minus 3, you get 0. See, 3 into minus 3. 3 into minus 3 means if minus digit is separately is there, fine. If it is not there and you press that minus sign, then you'll get 0. Because then into is not done, only minus is done. So you should do in calculator 3 into 3 only. And with your own logic, you know plus into minus is minus. Got it or not? Then 5 into 2 is 10, but minus 10. Plus into minus will become minus. 12 into 1 is 12. Plus into minus, minus. 16 into 0, 0. 11 into 1, 11. 5 into 2, 10. 4 into 3, 11. Now do minus 9. Minus 10. Minus 12. Plus 11. Plus 10. Plus 12. Do you all get it as 2? Any confusions? Now by below that you can write by shortcut method. X bar is equal to A plus sigma Fi Di upon N into C. Write that in bracket. What is bond mass? Brackets of division, multiplication, addition, subtraction. Okay? All the Padmash people clear? Okay, brackets of division, multiplication, addition and subtraction. Means, first you should do division, then you will do brackets of division, multiplication, addition, subtraction. First you will do division, then you will do addition with it. And write this in bracket, perform the calculations of bracket first. Otherwise in calculator if you do directly you get it wrong. So now assume mean we have taken as 35 plus in bracket sigma f by di we got 2 upon n we got 56 into class length is 10 sigma f by di is 2, n is the total of frequency, that is 56, and class length everywhere is 10. Okay, so don't do 35 plus 2 in calculator, you'll get it wrong. First you solve the bracket part. Understood this? So 35 as it is. Now what is 2 into 10 upon 56? 0.36. Doing 2 into 10 upon 56, we get 0.357.
Yes.
So 0.36. Now if you add it, 35.36. See, do we get the same answer or not?
Yes.
By both the methods?
Yes.
Understood this portion, everyone?
Yes.
Any conclusions?
No, sir.
Now one, I'll ask you. Okay, so now next question, you will explain me and then we'll solve two questions on your own. Look at question 5. The following information is available on the talk time. Just 1 minute before that, here write down thus the mean marks. Thus the mean marks of students is 35.36. Now look at question number 5. The following information is available on the talk time in minutes noted for 70 calls of a certain mobile phone user. Find the mean talk time. Now talk time, see, less than 4, less than 8, less than 12, less than 16, less than 20. You are given with less than type cumulative frequency distribution. Raise your hand, last chapter we studied. How will you convert less than into continuous? Raise your hand. How will you convert less than type frequency distribution into continuous frequency distribution? That's it. Only one person remembers it. Rima? No? Anyone else? Path?
Sir, first of all, we will form the classes 0 to 4, 4 to 8, and then from the frequency set.
What do all the classes tell me?
4 to 8, 8 to 12, 12 to 16, 16 to 28.
First class?
0 to 4.
Then?
Then from the last class, we will subtract 70 minus 65, that is 5. And similarly, we will see.
Yes. First of all, less than 4. So first class will be 0 to 4. Then 4 to 8. Less than 8 means 4 to 8. Then 8 to 12. 12 to 16. And less than 20 means last class will be 16 to 20. And what note did I make you write in the last chapter for obtaining the frequency? What note did I make you write in the last chapter for the frequency? Don't see. Domin?
Adding a...
That is when you make continuous to less than and more than. Amen? Subtract from highest CFI. Start subtracting from highest cumulative frequency. What is the highest cumulative frequency?
70.
From 70 you'll start subtracting, you'll get the frequency. 70 minus 65, 65 minus 57, 57 minus 42, 42 minus 20. Did you understand this or not?
Yes.
So, then converting, first we'll convert it into continuous, after that it is same. Converting the given less than time cumulative frequency distribution into continuous frequency distribution, we get, so classes will become less than 4 means first class will be 0 to 4, then 4 to 8, 8 to 12, 12 to 16, and less than 20 means last class will be 16 to 20. Understood that, everyone? And frequency will start subtracting from highest CFI. So 70 minus 65 is 5. 65 minus 57, 8. 57 minus 42, 15. 42 minus 20, 22. And first will remain 20 itself. Or 20 minus 0, 20. Are you all clear with it? Yes. Anyone having any doubt until here? Then, Sarvik, next step. What next state of mind?
Sir, xi.
Mid value xi, tell me.
Sir, 0 plus 4 divided by 2.
That is 2. Then?
4 plus 8 divided by 2.
Instead of that, what shortcut method I told you?
Sir, 4 plus 8.
What is the class length?
4.
Everywhere the class length is 4. Keep adding 4.
2 plus 4.
What is that?
6.
Then? 6 plus 4? 10. 10 plus 4? 14. 14 plus 4? 18. Do you all understand this shortcut method? First bit value 0 plus 4 divided by 2, then keep on adding the class length. Okay? Vanshita, what will we take? Assume to me? 10. Now, di is equal to what? Xi minus, what is k? 10 upon C, 4. Xi minus 10 upon 4. Did you understand this, everyone? Any doubts on this? Dhruvi, how will we directly write without any calculation?
When assuming 0, when minus 1, minus 2, minus, and 1 and 2.
Correct. Is everyone clear with this? In front of assumed mean 0, then minus 1, minus 2, and below that 1 and 2. Okay, then sing, what else is required? In the working, what else is needed?
Fi
into di. Tell me the values.
20.
What is that?
Minus
20 into minus 2, that is minus 40 then.
Minus
22 into minus 1, that is minus 22 then. 15 into 0 is 0. And you can do that in calculator, okay? Next. 8 into 1 is 8. And pi into 2 is 10. What mistake should not be done here? Xi di don't multiply by mistake. You have to take fi into
di.
Okay. Now, do minus 40 minus 22 plus 8 plus 10 minus 44.
Yes.
And we also need the total of fi, which is 70. Check it.
Yes, sir.
Last CFI is 70 in the question, so that itself will be the total of fi. All of you are clear with it? Now we write the formula. We'll be doing it by shortcut method only. So A plus in bracket sigma fi di upon n into C. Okay? So, Harmi, put the values.
Yes. 10 plus minus 44 upon 70 into 4.
Yes, pay attention. A is 10 plus sigma fi di is minus 44 upon n is 70 into class length, you can see is 4. Bhakti. Plus minus will become minus. Minus 2 point. 5. Do you all get minus 2.55? 5-1. Do you all get minus 2.51?
Yes.
So 7.49. Is everyone clear with this? Yes, madam. Is everyone clear with this? Thus, the mean talk time is 7.49 minutes. Understood this? I'm discussing 6 and 7, you will try on your own. Listen everyone. Sixth question. The information of profits of 50 firms is given below. Find the mean profit. First of all, 0 to 7, 7 to 14, 14 to 21, 21 to 28, 28 to 35. Are the class lengths equal or unequal?
Equal.
Okay. Akshar, what is the class length? Yes, 7 is the class length. Okay. First mid value, 0 plus 7 divided by 2, 3.5. Then what is the class length? Keep on adding 7. 3.5 plus 7, 10.5 plus 7, 17.5 and so on. Take 17.5 as assumed mean. 14 to 20 months mid value. All of you take same assumed mean so that we can verify the answers. 14 to 20 months mid value, 17.5 you'll take as assumed mean. Okay? You'll solve it by which method? Shortcut. But look at question 7. The distribution of demand of an item on different days is as follows. Find the mean demand. 5 to 14, 15 to 24, 25 to 34, but then 35 to 49, then 50 to 64 and 65 to 79. Class lengths are equal or unequal? So this you have to do by direct method. And every mid value you will have to calculate. Got it? Every mid value you will have to calculate. In 5 minutes both questions should be over. One more I have to solve in the class. Start solving it fast. Adil, is this a toy to play between the 15 minutes?
No.
Then why are you moving it again and again? There is not your game over here. If anything gets damaged then? Who gave you the authority? In the break of 15 minutes, no one will come on the stage henceforth. You were also there, Sanket. And there's Red Topi, Manish. What are you doing on the stage? Strict instruction in between 15 and no one will be standing out also. When I come, everyone should be inside. If I see anyone standing out, you'll go on there. All the formulas I'll make you sit out and write 100 times. When I enter into the complex, everyone should be inside the classroom only. And stay at your places, don't come on the stage. Completed? One question is over?
Yes.
I am doing 6th on the board. Those who have completed or not completed, verify your answers. Peer ended. Classes and frequencies 0 to 7, 7 to 14, 14 to 21, 21 to 28, 28 to 35 and 4, 9, 18, 12 and 7. Those who have done it or not done it will verify every one of you. Mid values will be 0 plus 7 divided by 2, 3.5. Then class length is equal everywhere 7, so you'll keep adding 7. So 3.5 plus 7, 10.5 plus 7. 17.5 plus 7, 24.5 plus 7, 31.5. 17.5 will take as assumed mean. Di will be xi minus a, that is 17.5, upon c, that is 7. Against a we will take 0, then minus 1, minus 2, 1 and 2. FITI. So these two will be multiplied. 4 into minus 2, minus 8. 9 into minus 1, minus 9. 18 into 0, 0. 12 into 1, 12. 7 into 2, 14. Do you get 9? Total of FITI. And this is 4, 13, 31, 43, 50. Now x bar is equal to a plus sigma FITI upon n into c. Assumed mean is 17.5 plus sigma FITI is 9 upon n is 50 into class length here is 7. What do you get 9 by 50 into 7? 1.26. So do you all get it as 18.76? Who all could get this correct? 18.76? Very good. Did you get the statement that the mean profit is 18.76 lakh rupees? You can see it's expressed in lakhs. So 18.76 lakh rupees. Then question number 7 also I am showing it. Classes and frequencies. Yes, maintain silence. 5 to 14. 15 to 24. 25 to 34. 35 to 49. 50 to 64. 65 to 79. Frequencies are 4, 17, 19, 22, 18 and 10. Now here class lengths are unequal, so we apply direct method. Okay. First mid value 5 plus 14, 19 divided by 2, 9.5. 15 plus 24, 39 divided by 2, 19.5. 25 plus 34, 59 divided by 2, 29.5. 35 plus 49, 84 divided by 2, 42. 50 plus 64, 114 divided by 2, 57. And 65 plus 79 divided by 2, 72. Do you all get this? Now, Fi, Xi we need means product of these two is required. This 4 into 9.5 is 38. What is 17 into 19.5? 1026. 18 into 57, 1026. And 720. 3600 90. So 40 is the answer. Sigma Fi Xi 3600 divided by N90, that is 40. Understood everyone? Any doubts on this? One more I have to take up today, then you'll lead. So look at exercise 3 section F question 2. Page 118. Page 118. Be a render market as important question. Section F question 2 market as important. Page 118. Exercise 3. Section F question 2. See what is asked to you is, two brands of tires are to be compared for the mean life. The following data are available. Can you see life is given in classes and then two brands of tires information is given, number of tires of brand A and number of tires of brand B. Two frequencies are given. will find two means here, brand A as well as brand B. And then on the basis of mean, we will find which brand of tires is better. Whosoever's mean comes more is better. How will you solve it? Understand the workings first, then you'll write it. See, classes are going to remain common in both. Classes are going to remain common. Therefore, mid value will also remain common. DI will also remain common. These three workings will be common for brand A as well as brand B. Now, brand A's frequency is given. So, for that, we will find FIDI. This is for brand A. Same way, brand B's frequency is given. For that, we will find FIDI. This is for brand B. This will be the workings we will need. Understood that? Everything of brand A I will do on the board, B you will try on your own. So, give this headings and write the informations given to you. Are class lengths equal or unequal?
Equal.
So we will be using the short method. Okay, write the classes and frequencies what are given to you for brand A and brand B in this manner. I'm proceeding with the calculations now. Listen everyone. 10 plus 15 divided by 2, 12.5. Check it, 10 plus 15 divided by 2, 12.5. Okay. Now can you see class lengths are equal? So we can keep on adding the class length. The class length is 5. So 12.5 plus 5, 17.5 plus 5, 22.5 plus 5, 27.5 plus 5, 32.5 plus 5, 37.5. Raise your hand who did not understand the mid values. All have understood, how is it obtained? Now suppose I select 22.5 as our assumed mean. Then in front of 22.5 I will write 0. Above that minus 1, minus 2. Below that 1, 2 and 3. Got it everyone? Now I am finding FIDI of A and you will find FIDI of B on your own. So FIDI means this 2 are to be multiplied. And when you do it for B, these 2 will be multiplied. Understood that? Raise your hand who did not understand. When we do it for A, then FIDI, this FIDI will be multiplied. And you do it for B, this FIDI will be multiplied. I am doing it for A and B, you will try on your own. Minus 2 into 4, minus 8. Minus 1 into 7, minus 7. 0 into 10, 0. 1 into 5, 5. 2 into 3, 6. 3 into 1, 3. Do it for B on your own. Who all have completed for B? Check it up. Minus 2 into 5, minus 10. Minus 1 into 8, minus 8. 0 into 15, 0. 1 into 9, 9. 2 into 6, 12. 3 into 2, 6. Do you all get this? Is it 9? And this total is 5, 13, 28, 45. Now, I am applying the formula of brand A. And brand B's formula you will apply on your own. First of all, write the formula. X bar equals to A plus sigma FIDI upon N into C. Okay, X bar equals to A plus sigma FIDI upon N into C. I am doing it for brand A. Now, be attentive. Brand A, the assumed mean is 22.5. Can you all see that? Plus sigma FID of brand A is minus 1. Can you all see this? Minus N of brand A is 30. And class length is same for both, that is 5. Okay. So 22.5, first we'll solve the bracket. Plus minus will become
minus.
Now do minus, do 1 into pi upon 13. 0.17. So 22.39. Do it for grand B on your own. Apply the same formula for grand B on your own. Did you get 23.5?
Yes.
Check it up everyone. A is again 22.5 plus sigma f by di is 9 upon n is 45 here into pi. So 22.5 plus 1, 23.5. Which tires are better?
B.
Then you'll write the conclusion. That's tires of brand B are better as its mean is more. Okay? See, homework, illustration 7, 8, 9. If class lengths are equal, use short method, unequal, use direct method. Exercise 3, section E, question 4. And this one is important, you will repeat. This question just now, what we did is important, you will repeat that. Okay? So, mean is over, arithmetic mean is over.